Hey, what is up guys, welcome back to Technotalks TV. Today in this video we are going to do an unboxing and first impressions of the Redmi Note 9. So this is considered to be the best budget phone currently, and there are reasons, because it has a great camera, it has a great processor, a pretty good display, and gives you a lot for the price. So today we will do an unboxing, see what comes in the box, and I will also give you my first impressions. By the way, the full review of this phone, it will be coming soon on this channel, so make sure you subscribe to Technotalks TV and hit the notification bell for all updates. Now let's get into the unboxing. So guys, here is the box packing of the Redmi Note 9. You can see it. It's mentioned Redmi Note 9 here. Now don't be confused by the color given on the box, because this is just the display color. So the model that I have is the 4GB 64GB scarlet red color. So it's the scarlet red color, not the aqua green that's given on the box. So on the back of the box you get all your specifications: 48 megapixel AI quad camera, 13 megapixel in display selfie camera, high performance Helio G85 processor, full HD plus display, 5020 milliamp hour battery, and all the other features that comes with this phone. So now let's open the box and see what comes in the box. Okay, here we go. So right after opening the box you will see this mini box. So let's see what comes in this mini box. Right after opening, you will get your SIM card tray ejector pin. This is your SIM card tray ejector pin. We'll just keep it back, so you have to use it to eject your SIM tray and put in your SIM and micro SD card there. Okay, so now after that we have our user manual and warranty card, and this phone comes with 12 months of warranty, and all the accessories that comes in the box come with 6 months of warranty. So this is the warranty card and the manual. Then we have a clear TPU case. This is a clear TPU case for the phone itself. The quality is average quality, not very good, but it's fine for the price. Okay, so now we have the phone. Whoops, I just took out the charger as well. So this is the phone. Let's keep it aside. And this is just a cover. Then we have a 22.5 watt fast charger. You can see the output is written 5 volts 3 amps. That means it's a 22.5 watt fast charger. But the interesting thing is the phone supports only 18 watt of fast charging. So I don't get the point of a 22.5 watt fast charger in the box, but still you get it, that's nice. And then finally you get a USB type A to type C cable that you have to attach to the charger and use it to charge the phone. So now let's keep everything aside. Okay, so this is the phone. Here we go. Whoa, look at that color. Look at that color. That is awesome. Scarlet red. Let me show you. Now, when light falls on it, it's amazing. That's a really nice color. So yeah, it's a nice color. I really like this color, but the problem is this is glossy and this will catch so many fingerprints. Even if you just touch it once, it will catch fingerprints. That's going to be an issue. We can't do anything, but you can just attach the case. So let's attach the case. So now I have attached the case, it still catches fingerprints on the case itself, but you know, it's less. So now I will charge it, put my micro SD card in it, just do the basic setup and then come back to you guys. So now I have done all the basic setup. I have logged into my Google account. I have put my micro SD card in this phone. I have charged it up to 69%, and it charges pretty fast. You know, 18 watt fast charging for a 5000 milliamp hour battery is definitely slower than some other chargers, but it takes about 1.5 hours to fully charge the battery. Now first, let's talk about in-hand feel. Now this phone is big, like this is a really big phone, you know, 6.53 inch screen diagonal measure. It's pretty wide, it's on the wider side, not like other phones which are narrower and taller, but it's wider and shorter in height. Yeah, so it feels quite good in the hand. As I told you in the unboxing, it catches fingerprint like anything, so you know, I hope it was a matte back, so that would have been really great, but this color is also not bad at all. Now let's talk about the display, and it's something to appreciate about this phone, because at this price point you are getting a full HD plus IPS LCD display. Now of course it's not AMOLED or fast refresh rate, 90 hertz refresh rate like the Realme 7 and other phones at this price point, but you know, it's a good display. I would say 60 hertz is fine for me. I have never used 90 hertz, so it's not at all a problem for me, so I'm fine with this display. I hope it was AMOLED, that would have enabled always on display on this, but there's no always on display because this is not an AMOLED display. Otherwise the display is pretty good. The viewing angles are average, I would say, and you know, it's big. As I told you, it's quite big. It's good for multimedia. Now it has a hole punch cutout on the top left corner. I think top left corner is more preferred by me rather than just a center hole punch cutout or a dewdrop notch, because that just distracts you. This just fades away when you are like watching videos or doing something in the landscape orientation. You just don't notice it. So that's really, really nice that it's here. Now let's get into cameras, because this has pretty impressive cameras. Now let's talk about the sensors that it comes with. It has a main sensor, 48 megapixel main sensor. It has an 8 megapixel ultra wide, a 2 megapixel depth, and a 2 megapixel macro camera. So the 2 megapixel cameras are, nah, they are just not good. The macro camera is very bad. Like really bad. If you just take an image with the main sensor and just crop into it, I think that will be way better than just taking a photo with the macro camera. That's just to make it a quad camera, right? You know, we know this. Now the camera quality, I would say it rivals some 15,000, 16,000 rupees phones. By the way, I will tell you the price at the end of this video. So it rivals 15,000 and 16,000 rupees phones in terms of the camera. The ultra wide, that's where it falls behind of the other phones, because most phones have a 13 megapixel ultra wide sensor. This has only an 8 megapixel ultra wide sensor, so it's not as sharp as the main sensor, but still you do have an ultra wide. You could use this for you know, vlogging or taking wide images of landscapes or groups, so that's nice. The depth sensor, it's used for portrait mode. Portrait mode works pretty well. The edge detection is average quality. I would not say it's very high-end edge detection or something like that. So the edge detection is good, not great. The macro sensor, as I told you, you could get quite close with the macro sensor, but still it is not sharp. It is not sharp at all. Just don't trust it. Just take an image with the 48 megapixel sensor and just crop into it. Now let's talk about the selfie camera. The selfie camera is a 13 megapixel in-display selfie camera, so it's a hole punch cutout. It's not an older notch. I hate notches. I just love this hole punch cutout. The selfie camera, it's good for the price, but I don't think it's a good selfie camera at all. It's just grainy, does not have detail in it. It just cannot use it for low light shots. That's impossible to do with this phone. It does not have night mode. It has only two modes, photo and video and portrait mode. So you could only use those three modes. And then that, it's a pretty good, not good, I will say average, above average camera setup for the price. I will get into the software of the camera in my full review, so stay tuned for that. Now let's talk about all the sensors. Now it has all sensors, gyroscopes, accelerometers, light sensor, proximity sensor, every sensor, all the basic sensors it has. It has also an optical fingerprint reader on the back, which is pretty fast. So you can trust it, you can rely on it. It's really fast. You could register up to 6 fingerprints. Also, it has face unlock, which works pretty well, I would say. And it's really fast. And you get a little animation on the top when it's not locked. And when it's unlocked, you get this tick animation. So you have to just swipe up and it's going to unlock. So the face unlock and fingerprint sensor are really, really fast. And those are good for the price. Now, finally, let's talk about my overall first impressions. This phone is pretty good for the price. I could say that. You know, I could recommend this phone to anyone who's looking for a phone under 12,000 rupees. And the 4GB, 64GB variant of this phone comes in at 11,500 rupees. There are two other models, the 4GB 128GB and the 6GB 128GB. So if you want more storage or if you want more RAM according to your usage, you could get the other variants. But for me, 4GB, 64GB was the best option. So I got it on the Amazon Great Indian Festival. So the price was less by 500 rupees. And then, you know, with the 10% off on SBI cards, it finally came down to a price of 9,900 rupees. So keep an eye on sales if you are going to buy this phone, because it drops, you know, the price drops quite frequently. So that is it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed this video, do hit the like button. And I will be talking about the software and the, you know, processor and the other hardware components in my full review. So make sure you subscribe to TechnoTalks TV for more interesting tech videos like this. That is it, guys, for me. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.